Minecraft with me at play.noobcraft.net. Hello everyone. I'm in a pretty good mood right now. Yes, a pretty good mood indeed. Any ideas why, Pinchy? No, that's not it. Guys, today is the first episode of Noobcraft. Episode one,
no.
Sir Meow's Hut. Sorry, I didn't mean to scare you. For those of you who don't know, I opened up a Minecraft server. But not just any Minecraft server, a Minecraft server where you guys can come and play Minecraft with me. You can be in the server with me as I make this series. And it's a lot more than just that. It's not just any Minecraft server. Guys, noobcraft.net. If you want to join it in-game, I'll show you right here. The server address is play.noobcraft.net on Minecraft Java Edition. And whenever you hop on in, well, there's just a whole boatload of things to explore, and I'll be showing you guys all of that today. I want to make sure that I can get through absolutely everything, or at least as much as I can. There's no way I'm gonna get through everything because there is so much. There is an incredible amount of stuff to do in this. So when you first spawn in, you see this beautiful Noobcraft logo. Oh, guys, let's get a closer zoom in for all of its glory. There it is. Oh, I'm so happy with how it turned out. Okay, so what is Noobcraft? What do you do when you first join? So Noobcraft, when you first join, you will see 4 different realms to choose from, and each realm is completely unique to itself. Whatever's happening in one realm is completely different in another one, so your items and whatnot don't transfer over. So you can technically have like 4 different characters or 4 different playthroughs, whatever. Let's go into the Diamond Realm, which is the one that I play in. And so whenever you guys come in to play Noobcraft, if you'd like to play with me in the Diamond Realm, you will require a Diamond Access Pass. But anyways, so what happens when you first join in? Well, there's this beautiful little spawn area, which I will show everything off fairly soon. I think we should just jump right into the actual gameplay of it. So there's the island panel right here, which allows you to create your island. You can go ahead and right click on the NPC there. And then there's a bunch of different islands you can choose from. So this is a Skyblock server, but it's not just any Skyblock server. There is a incredible amount of things to do. I really wish I could just spew all the information at once because all of it is so exciting to me, but we're just gonna have to go one step at a time. We gotta make an island. This is going to be the island that we play for the entirety of the series, pretty much. I mean, I don't know, we'll see what can happen, but because you can also make multiple islands and whatnot. Ah, there's just so much to get through. Okay, one step at a time. I need to keep reminding myself that. Let's make an island. There's a normal island, a desert one, a jungle one, an ice one. There's all these different islands you can choose from. If you want to know what the island looks like before you actually go ahead and lock it in, well, let's say, for example, let's check out the mine island. So you can right click to preview the island. So there it is. So if we chose the mine island, then this would be our sky block here. And you know, yeah, it looks pretty nice, not too bad. I actually do like it quite a bit. I would also like to quickly preview the normal one, because I mean, we can always go ahead and open new islands later in the series, but you know, let's see what we need to do for a nice, genuine starting experience. What do you say? And one thing I'd like to let you guys know is, even though I do technically have like the owner tag beside my name and whatnot, I have completely normal player permissions. There's nothing about my character that is any different than a normal player. So what I wanted to make sure was that everything you guys see in this series is the actual true player experience. That means I have no permissions, I have no special abilities, I don't even have like a rank or anything that you can get from the shop. Let's go ahead and make an island. I actually really like this mine island. There's all these other ones that you guys can check out for yourselves. The islands are also unique to each different realm. So the aqua realm, for example, will have some more sort of aquatic themed islands, which is really, really cool. But let's go ahead and create a mine island, and we can enter an island name. Let's go ahead and just call it Noobcraft. Ladies and gentlemen, our home, here it is. It's very, very nice, and as you can maybe see momentarily, there's already some things like iron ore, and I even think there might be some diamond more towards the bottom. And you might think at first, like, whoa, skyblock, like, you don't want to be getting all these things right away. Well, Let me tell you guys, when I say that this is very different than just normal Minecraft Skyblock, it's a completely different game. Because, well, first off, I'll show you the most important command by far is /is, and this opens up your island control panel. This is where you can do everything with your island, customize it, and make it completely 100% your own. You can manage all the players that are in your island, you can create a team, then you can go and fight other forces and get a bunch of loot, and we will see all of this in the series in due time. I just want to make sure that you guys understand just how much there is to do, but I suppose I'll keep giving myself that one friendly reminder to just calm down and play, even though I'm shaking with excitement. So first things first, when it comes to Skyblock, what do? You got to make a generator. So there are all these different island options. Just I thought I'd let you guys know. We won't really look too much into it right now, but /is is the command. You can also just go /island. It does the exact same thing in case you forget. We gotta make a generator. So there is the starting loot, which is pretty typical in a lot of Skyblock. You got the lava and then the ice to make the generator and whatnot. But how do you make a generator? We could give ourselves a quick friendly reminder. I would like to make a pickaxe before anything. We do have this lovely tree right here, which I'm going to completely destroy, because what I kind of want to do is I want to make this Skyblock like its completely own little world. Maybe even like a little town or something like that. What I was planning on doing is inviting some other people on the Diamond Realm to just come hang out. I'll probably give them some sort of permissions where they can't necessarily like destroy a bunch of things, but they can always just come hang out on my Skyblock specifically. So you can invite players to your Skyblock and whatnot whenever you go here to the team, and then there's different, you can invite a player, you can give people very specific roles and permissions within it. So that's what I was kind of planning to do. But also what I'd like to do right off the bat is the subscriber of the day. That's right, guys, we're carrying over the tradition from Minecraft Aquatic Adventures, bringing it on to Noobcraft. So here's how it's gonna work. I decided that this time, rather than it just being a name on a sign, we can go ahead and do Minecraft player heads, and then it's a lot more physical and like visible. You can see exactly who the subscriber is. You can put a face to it. So I think that's so much better. So guys, I have this command here that allows me to type in any player's Minecraft name, and then it should give me their head. Now keep in mind that this is Minecraft Java Edition, but if you would like your Minecraft head in my Skyblock, all you gotta do is comment your Minecraft name down below, hit that subscribe button, and then you got a chance of being chosen next episode. Now, because this is episode 1, and there's no comments to look from, I decided that I'm going to choose one of the first people that I saw in the Diamond Realm whenever the server first opened yesterday, and that would be, he's actually online right now, you can see him in the chat, that would be your boy, Grams. I hope I'm pronouncing it right. I think it's Grams. I don't know what else it would be. But it's this cute little cow man wearing sunglasses. So that's going to be the first head. But going forwards, I'll be choosing from the comment section whenever you guys leave your Minecraft names below. We need a lava bucket. I have some wood here to go ahead and create a crafting table. It feels so weird starting from scratch. Because Minecraft Aquatic, we were so deep into it. I don't know. It's so weird. We were like 75 episodes in, and now we're starting from scratch. Unbelievable. It's getting a little bit dark. Wouldn't mind some torches. We got some starting coal. Actually, we got some starting torches. There you go. Okay, cool. Let's get some cobble. We could do it from a generator, but I'll show you guys exactly why it's probably a good idea to have a stone pickaxe first. So let's make, I'll get a furnace going as well, actually. You guys will see very, very quickly why this is so different than just very, very normal Minecraft Skyblock that you would just like download the map for or something. So, let's see here. We do have enough for what I want, I believe. We need the furnace. Good. And then we need, we just need an iron pick. Not an iron pick, a stone pick, actually. What I'm gonna do is, I don't know where to put Graham's head for now. I'll just put him right here, but I will make a actual little, like, place where I place all the heads nicely and stuff. It's gonna look great. But if I want to go back to the realm lobby, you can just go slash spawn in chat, and then you gotta be standing still. You just gotta wait a couple seconds. It'll teleport on over. And then when we're back here, this is where we can now make use of all of the cool little things you can do in the spawn area. So there's all these different cool little things you can do, like you can place bounties on people. The only bounty right now is on me. So how this works is you essentially place a value on someone else's head. If this person is in the bounties list and that person gets killed, If someone kills me in the, like, the PvP arena, for example, they will be rewarded 990 in-game currency from whoever placed this bounty. And then there's some other cool stuff here where you can get these little different drinks and stuff where you put in a little bit of money and then you can maybe get some more in return. So just these fun little things you can do. So over the course of the series, we'll see every little thing that the server has to offer. So I won't be going into extreme detail with everything. Noobcraft is filled with custom enchantments. If you just go slash CE, I believe that works, or you can just go slash enchantments, it will show you all of the different custom enchantments that Noobcraft has. And it is a crazy, crazy, crazy amount. Like, let's say, for example, Haunted automatically pick up drops into your... Oh, wait, that's Magnet now. Hold on. Did I just switch off it? Haunted. There we go. But Magnet's a cool one, too. Automatically pick up drops into your inventory, so you don't actually have to, like, walk up to it and it just appears in your inventory. That's really cool. And then it shows you the type, like what kind of item you would put it on. And the way this works is whenever you get levels in game, which you can either just buy with the in-game currency or you can like get it normally, you can come over to the enchanter, get different enchantments that cost a certain amount of XP, and then you can redeem it and you'll get a custom enchantment, and then you can apply it to really whatever item you want. So I'm excited to start being able to do that. But let's come over here. I'll show you how the generators work. So this is just a demo cobblestone generator. It's the same kind of generator you would make in any Skyblock series ever. However, though, there's something a little bit different about this server, is that it's not just cobblestone that can spawn whenever you're mining this little part right here. As you can see, it could be stone, iron, gold, diamond, or emerald. And then they each have a very small different chance of spawning. So it just makes it a little more interesting, which I really like. And then this right here just puts you into your island. I'm just going to teleport to island home. We're back in here. So now that we saw exactly how the generators work, you know, just to refresh it in our heads, we will make sure that we don't mess this up, because I am very, very, very known for completely ruining my first generators anytime I try to play Skyblock. So, okay, if I put that there, I'm gonna move it over slightly this way. Here we go. Okay, cool. So lava would go here, then the water would go there, right? We should put this over here so that none of the wood gets burned up. I don't actually know if that would happen. Oh wait, I have lava right here, but I need water. Okay, so I do need a little thingy of ice. Boop. And then we go boop. Okay, so this should work, I hope. Please. I can't, I know that it seems super easy, but I can't explain to you guys just how much I messed this up. So whenever I do that, hey, there you go. So we got some iron. And just like that, we can go ahead and keep going, and we'll get some good resources to start off. So just like that, I should probably cover this so that we don't keep having our items burned up. But I have seen some absolutely ridiculous islands already on the server. Okay, I think it's time for an iron pick. Let's go on down here. So while I get my initial starting resources, let's maybe do a little bit of a discussion on exactly what I'm planning to do with everything here. So I think my overall kind of end goal is to have this empire of an island where we got a big team and there's like different buildings and houses, and we combine all our efforts together to be able to go into the PvP arenas and get the best loot and all that. Essentially just be the superpower, but I want to do it perfectly legitimately, and you guys are gonna see it grow over the course of the series. What's the next thing we should do? Well, I mean, let's go ahead and maybe start cooking up some iron here. So as you can see, there's also different little skills in game, so whenever it's just MCMMO, whenever you are doing things like, for example, mining, you do get some not just normal Minecraft experience but also MCMMO experience, where you can then get different abilities through that too. Like, so say for example, if I right click while holding my pickaxe, you ready your pickaxe, and I'm now all of a sudden going really fast. But it only works for a little bit because we're only like level 1 right now when it comes to MCMMO, or something like that. What does it say in the chat? Mining skill increased by 1, total 7. Oh, maybe we're on level 7 right now, actually. I was playing this a little bit yesterday. I tried having most things wiped. I think there's still a couple things that aren't exactly in place yet. There might be a couple of hiccups with the server, guys, as well, because anytime a new Minecraft server is released, there's always certain things that you can't really account for, but don't worry, everything will be perfectly flushed out, and it's gonna be great. Let's get cooking. And in the meantime, while we wait for that to cook, let's go back to slash spawn, and I want to show you guys some crates. That's right, it can give us a nice little starting boost for our island. Whenever you first come into spawn here, you can go left here to the crates area. Well, actually, I shouldn't say that, because each realm spawn is different. It's, like I said, it's unique to each realm, but it's usually very, very simple, where you just follow the path, and then you pretty much can't miss whatever the spawns have to offer. But you can check out all your crate keys here, and as we can see, for example, we have 4 voting crates, because what I did earlier today is, if I did go ahead and go slash vote in chat, you can vote for this server, and you can get some free stuff for it. So there's some there's voting rewards that you can get, and essentially what voting is you vote for the server on a little server list online, and then you get some in-game rewards for it. So I went ahead and did that through the slash vote menu, and I got some voting crate keys. So let's go ahead and redeem the voting crate key. So you can left click to open crate, and here we go. It's just like a little slot machine type of deal. So we got a free item. What did we get? We got a creeper spawner. Ooh. So let me tell you guys exactly how each island works in terms of its value and the superior island. There are many different reasons why you want to try to be building up and growing your island as much as you can. Because if you go to this leaderboard area, not only can we see here who has the most money and then the most valuable island, but you also get rewards if you are one of the top here in the leaderboard area. So the top 3 islands every single week will be rewarded Noobcraft store gift cards. First place would be, I think it's a $65 Noobcraft gift card. And then second place is, I don't remember exactly, I wanna say it's like 25, and then third place is 10. But that's every single week. And then that's based on your island's level or worth. And I'll tell you guys how that works now. I want to go ahead and I will actually use one more voting crate. We could just use all of them. Why not? Might as well give ourselves a little head start. So voting crate key, here we go. I really wouldn't mind a diamond sword if it would stop on that one there. Ooh. So we got 30 MCMMO credits. Okay, sweet. And that was a 5% chance of getting that too. So we can use that to get some MCMMO rewards. I'll figure that out in a second. I honestly don't know too much about MCMMO, but let's go ahead and go voting crate key again. I love this cute little animation that happens. What do we got? What do we got? Come on. Show me the money. Ooh, 12,500. That's not so bad. We only had 1,000 monies and now we got 12,500. Okay, last voting crate key. What do we got? Show me the money. So what is this? 25,000. Oh, 25,000. Cool. So now we're at 38,000 monies. Hello there, green, blue Lego. That's a little bit contradictory, isn't it? How can something be both green and blue? Although I do believe that is how colors work. You can mix colors together, I suppose. Anyways, let's go back to our island. I can just go /is/home. Grams, that is a terrifying skin, but I love it. IS home. We could go ahead and place this creeper spawner. That wouldn't be so bad. There's some achievements we can go. Let's go /achievements. And there's a bunch of custom achievements that we can do in game. So very similar to Minecraft Aquatic Adventures, we're of course going to be tackling the Noobcraft achievements. And you get new achievements as you progress. And so the first ones here is, say for example, kill 1,000 blaze, kill 100 iron golems, kill 100 mobs with a bow. That's something that we could start working on. Place 25 creeper spawners and then plant 250 carrots. Okay, so a lot of this stuff might seem like a lot, but trust me guys, things grow really, really fast in a server like this. Let me tell you, pretty soon we'll be seeing like for example, we have 38,000 monies right now. People are gonna be in the billions. Like, it's gonna get pretty insane. And this is only like the first day after launch that I'm playing. So what you're seeing right now, everything is brand new. It's perfectly fresh. I would like to just make a nice little area for this creeper spawner. I believe the creepers aren't actually hostile. I don't think that's how it works, but I don't really know. So we're taking a bit of a risk here, but that's fine. Let's say now we do have some iron to work with here, but maybe before we make an iron pick, here's an idea. We have 38,000 monies right now. If we go /shop, every item in Minecraft you can buy through /shop using the in-game money. So that's another reason why it's very different, because you can get items without having to specifically do the normal steps that it takes. So, for example, if we want a diamond pickaxe, rather than getting 3 diamonds and crafting one, what if we went ahead and went to the tools section and then got a diamond pickaxe for 1,000 monies? Why not? Boom. We go ahead and, oh right, that doesn't actually buy it. It brings you to the transaction area. And then there's a bunch of different things you can do here. You can either just buy one, you can buy a stack, or there's some other options here as well. But we're just gonna start with buying one single diamond pickaxe. And there we have it. Like I said, this is very, very different than how normal Minecraft works. And so it might seem like at first it's like, wow, Dennis, you just started and you got a diamond pickaxe? I mean, come on. But trust me, guys, it'll make a lot more sense as we go forwards. The progression is very, very, very different than how normal Minecraft works. So having a diamond pickaxe, even having full diamond armor, it really doesn't mean that much in the grand scheme of things, just because of all the different customization and stuff that happens in this server. I know it's a lot. I understand I'm explaining a lot right now, and I do apologize if you guys really do just want to see the gameplay going, but there is just so much to cover, and it is going to be a little bit of a learning process myself as well, just because I haven't actually done a full out playthrough on this because obviously the server just opened. I suppose let's just keep going then with the island. We could just do some mining here, and then whenever we get resources from this, we could sell it on the shop. There's also an auction house where we can auction off things if you go /ah. So someone is selling a creeper spawner right now for 600,000 monies. That seems like a lot, Mr. Frying Pan. I don't really know if I want to do that. But you know what else you can do? This is actually super, super cool. You can go /coin flip. And what you can do with /coin flip is you can put up a coin flip game and bet against other people. Essentially just go heads or tails. So let's say, for example, if I want to put in a new bet, I can go coin flip bet. Let's bet coin flip new. And then the bet would be 5,000 monies. And we're going to go heads. So there we go. I'll just say in the chat, someone face me in my coin flip. And then I'll just give a nice friendly reminder to do /coin flip. Oh, there we go. Someone's doing it. Okay, I am legit Oh no, he won! It landed on Tails! Aww. all right. Well played. So there you go, guys. That's how that works. We just lost 5,000 monies. I would like to make a bed. That would be nice. Just so that we can get through the nighttime. I'm gonna go back to slash shop here. Let's go ahead and buy ourselves a bed. I can go ahead and buy some wool, actually. So I'll go ahead and buy 3 of those. And then we have some wood already. So let's go ahead and make ourselves a bed. There you go. Easy. Right here. Go ahead, go to bed. I just slipped off the bed. What happened there? I didn't even know that was possible. So it doesn't actually look like it becomes daytime when you sleep in the bed. I'm not entirely too sure why that's the case. I'm pretty sure it's supposed to, but like I said, there might be some hiccups with the server. I don't really know. Anytime something like this happens, I do quickly mention it to the dev and then they take down some notes. So I don't know. Bear with me, guys. But anyways, though, let's see. What else is there to do now? Let's go ahead and suppose we could work on taking down this tree. What I would like to do, like, sooner rather than later, is have one of those, like, crazy ore generators where it's, like, you use a bunch of pistons, and then it makes a massive wall of ores. I'll show you guys that soon enough. It's really crazy what some people have done. I'm not sure if I'm still in someone's island that has that. I believe I just have mine. Yeah, okay. I was in someone's island earlier during the stream that had a crazy generator, but it doesn't look like I have that anymore in my list, but we'll figure that out very soon. I don't know why these creepers aren't spawning either. I'm gonna go ahead and give them a little bit more room. Maybe it's because there's some light right nearby. Is that what we need to do? We need to get rid of these torches, maybe. Oh yeah, I'll put a light right there, but that should be fine. Should be able to. Here, what if I cover it up? I don't know, it's looking pretty dark over there. I want to get started on that tree. Let's go slash shop, going over to PvP, buy ourselves an axe. Why not? There we go. I'll see if I can use my MC MMO abilities to just rip her down. I think I'll probably start. I'll start from the top. It'd be weird going from down here and then, it just wouldn't really work. We gotta go from the very top, work our way down. This is a very, very big tree. We will get a lot of wood from this. Okay. Did I just see something there? What spawned over there? What is that? You guys see that? Am I crazy? It was a flower. It was a flower. Let's go to the very tippy top here. And you guys might be wondering, like, what's this weird, strange little border going on? You see all this? Well, that is the little island border that you can actually upgrade with island tokens and whatnot. Again, we'll take a look at all that later. Just thought I'd let you guys know in case you were curious. Let's see. So I got this diamond axe, and I want to make sure I'm near a big branch of wood so that whenever I use my MCMMO ability, it goes absolutely nuts.
Go get a little bit you right here. Go ahead, get some more right here too.
Here we go. This is where all the wood is at. Okay, good. This is a very, this is a very big tree.
Just barely reach it there. There we go.
Ooh, and we're also getting some MCMMO levels right there too. I feel like a lot of this wood is, it is falling off the island. That's just great. Well, here we go though. I think we got most of the top parts here. Let me see.
It just gotta barely reach it. Okay, hold on. I gotta jump up. Hit that.
There's so much wood. There's still more up there. This is such a big tree. Okay, I believe that's all of it. I'm definitely gonna miss a piece somewhere, and then it's gonna be really difficult to get this whole tree taken down. There's a little piece right there, a little secret piece. There you go. I see you hiding over there. Okay, cool. But now, will you ready your axe? Whoa! Okay. I was not ready for that. That was crazy. It just got rid of like all of the wood. Okay. Well, that was pretty sick. So yeah, what I want to do, guys, is like, I want to make the sky block not at all look like what we started with. Like, I want it to end up being very, very different. And I don't know, I was thinking of making like a full out platform with grass and dirt, like probably make it a couple of layers and make it seem like an actual nice proper little world. And then if I invite some of you guys to come in and play with me on the island, then we can have like a little town with different people's houses. And it would just be so cool. I don't know. That's kind of the end goal for me, I think. And if we want to be trying to level up our island and get it to be the highest level it can be, the way that works is, so your island's worth is dependent on the value of blocks that are in your island. So let's say, for example, a diamond block is a lot more valuable than a block of dirt. So if you have more diamond blocks in your island, then the higher level your island is going to be. So that's kind of how the worth is judged. So what a lot of people do is they literally just make these like island banks, or they just have islands dedicated to storing thousands and thousands of like diamond or emerald blocks and stuff like that. It's insane what people do. I mean, obviously we want to do some sort of version of that. I doubt that we'll be able to do anything ridiculously crazy, but I don't know, maybe if we make like a really, really nice ore generator and stuff like that, then it'll work out great. So yeah, and then especially if we have some team members in here as well to help out. We got a couple things that we can smelt right here. Go ahead and make some iron and then some gold ore. Probably could use some more furnaces. Yeah, let's maybe go ahead and do that. I'll go ahead and make one more. Well, guys, I think this was a pretty decent sort of little intro video. I hope that I didn't just throw too much information at you guys. Like I said, like there is just a crazy, crazy amount of things that you can do in this server, and I really, really hope that we tackle as much as possible as fast as possible. Are there still some logs in there somewhere? I'll probably take care of that off recording. Similarly to what we were doing with Aquatic Adventures, there's going to be a lot of things that I'll be doing. Yeah, like I said, like a little either off recording, or maybe I'll get some team members in here as well and then they can help out. But another thing I'd like to mention, guys, is that I do plan on spending time on Noobcraft even outside of recordings like this. So if you want to come on in and play, don't think that it's only going to be when I'm recording Noobcraft. I plan on hanging out. There's a bunch of different events that happen in the server and whatnot, and it's super, super fun, and I love just hanging out with you guys. So go ahead and check it out, play.noobcraft.net. Add it to your Minecraft server list. That's pretty much it, guys. I'm gonna leave it off here. I think we this was a nice little intro. We got the basics out of the way. Anyways though, guys, again, thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed, please do remember to leave it a like, maybe even subscribe if you haven't already, and play.noobcraft.net. Go ahead and check it out. Thank you again, guys, and I will see you in the next one.